representing your country and showing up and putting in the time. And I think from an identity perspective, you know, we're also evolving to some younger athletes that are really exciting, that are, you know, yeah, they want to play for Canada. They want to make a living playing this game. And even beyond, they want to be doing what you're doing. And so opportunities in the sport are important for us.
How about a little bit of pride, a 24-second shot clock violation, and that always fires. Listen, you're a coach, you're a player, you're a fan. You get fired up with those, right? That's when you talk about pride. Sitting down and earning those are big time. I want to ask you about an individual, a woman here with the 905 organization. You know her well, Tammy Sutton Brown. She's the associate of basketball and franchise operations this year with the 905. But can you speak a little bit, tell us a little bit about Tammy, because I remember growing up watching her as a player, how much I loved her, but you know her better than probably most people.
Well, actually, I first met Tammy when she was in probably eighth grade, and I was actually coaching and helping with the provincial teams. I was a university coach. I'd come back from playing professionally, and to just see her as a young woman grow into the player that she became, and that at such a young age, at the 2000 Olympics, just her being so dominant and being such a force, and then to watch her make the WNBA, one of our, you know, first females to ever, and to have that long a career, she has paved the way for others to dream.
Absolutely, and you mentioned something so important, because the women's basketball community is so small, as I've mentioned earlier on this broadcast. Tammy Sutton Brown actually did a workshop camp with me and my team itself. So, you know, it's all about passing down to the next generation. So when I look at the current women who are playing the game, I think of Kia Nurse, of course, and she's doing broadcasts, and she's playing her heart out in Phoenix right now. You know, how does that translate to the next generation when they see leaders coming up?
You know what? Every one of our players know they have a responsibility to give back to the next generation and to honor those that came before them. And that has been something that we've started from the time that I started with Bev Smith as a head coach, who had played it as one of our all-time greatest. Wow. And so to hear a 16-year-old like Leticia Amihir or Shayna Pellington or the next generation even speak about, I'm a role model. And we talk about it in international team camps with the young under 16, under 17. So it is really important.
And I do. And so it's amazing to see that growth and development. It's definitely a male-dominated industry, and I always get so excited when you see women who work with us.
And I think a lot of women in this industry, we wear multiple hats all the time, too. Nikki is a great example. She's our camera operator for tonight, but she's also the in-arena host for the Toronto Blue Jays as well. So, you know, they hold their own. We have it, you know, we have to wear a lot of hats before we go on air, or even when we're on air. You know, I'm also a producer behind the scenes.
I was going to say.
With some other content I'm working on featuring the lovely Amy Otterbird as well.
Yeah, I mean, we just, it's absolutely precious. I mean, this young woman's development's been crazy. I've been watching Sav do this for years, so I'm so happy we get to do this together. But Denise, we'll bring you back in, Executive Vice President of Women's High Performance for the Canadian National Women's Program. I love saying that. That's so awesome to hold that. And that we were kind of getting into the WNBA a little bit. Again, I don't think there's anyone that disagrees. We'd love to see a new team up here, but there's just got to be more teams. Tell us a bit about the development of talent in that league.
Yeah, I think, you know, there's opportunities here for the WNBA to expand. The talent is there. I think from a business model perspective, they've looked at making it sustainable. It's been, you know, supported by the NBA, and I think it should be. And, you know, it's the growth in their development as a collective of franchises. I think it's time to open the gates.
Yes.
and let a few more teams in, and certainly Canada would be an amazing spot, and having both Toronto and Vancouver, I hear, would be great spots.
That'd be wonderful. Listen, I mean, Vancouver too, wow.
Oh.
I want to give you a couple minutes. I just want to kind of brag and highlight some of our younger women. Cheyenne Day Wilson just won ACC Freshman of the Year at Duke. I got to go call her game earlier this season, which was really cool. But I mean, there's so many awesome young women, and can you kind of touch on a couple that are really coming up?
Real quick, Amy, you know, just to jump on Cheyenne Day Wilson, Delano Banton told me that's his favorite female player in the game of basketball. He said that's his favorite soon-to-be WNBA player.
Listen, that would be the ultimate pick-and-pop combo.
Oh, yeah.
Right? He knows.
Yeah. No, for sure, Shy is really, I mean, just vaulted in her first year here at Duke, and, you know, speaking to her coach, they're really happy with her. You know, it's usually a big transition, but for her, what impresses me is her confidence. She has put in the time as a young athlete while back here in Toronto and is super confident, and I think that's an important certainly aspect of playing the game. And so to come in first year, win freshman of the year of the ACC is huge, and a tribute to her, the time that she's put in.
not quite as young, but Bridget Carlton, I love watching. And I mean, the space that she's kind of carved out at Minnesota under Cheryl Reeve, I mean, that is not an easy place. And playing with Nat Achanwa, tell us a little bit about Bridget. I can't get enough of watching her play.
Yeah, so for Bridget, I think, you know, there's what I would say to the viewers and all those who decide to make a decision about their post-secondary choices. It is a crucial decision and a difficult one.
Yep.
And there's a lot of noise, but you've got to pick the best context for your development and make sure that you're asking the right questions. And Bridget did that. She went to a school where she got to play multiple positions, and she got time in her first year onwards and grew tremendously through those 4 years.
Yeah, at Iowa, it was wonderful watching her. And actually, I was calling her first WNBA game when she checked in. I was with the Atlanta Dream, and she had checked in with the Connecticut Sun. And I think when you're Canadian and you see Canadians that exceed at that level, you just have so much pride. And that was wonderful. So I'm really looking forward to seeing our young women thrive. And I mean, before you know it, it's going to be another Olympic year, right? I mean, time
exactly.
is just flying. So.
Yeah, absolutely. And you mentioned something, Denise, how picking a school is crucial. I always tell the next generation who's in that situation where they have to decide which school they're going to go to next, that is probably, no pressure, the most important decision of your life, at least for a long time it is. So it really does alter the course of your career. As Reggie Perry throws that one down hard, you know he's going to come out strong. And the Raptors, on our back, they have full control over this game right now. They're leading by 20. This is why we're able to banter so much, because, you know, they have such a solid lead, Amy.
Reggie Perry, to your point, is one of those guys that can do a little bit of everything, right? I mean, he's listed as a big, but he can shoot a three, powerful and explosive. Look at him deny right there up the lane. He's, oh yeah, a little too much contact for coach, and or for the official. Coach doesn't like it. Denise likes the finesse. I'm okay with the bang game, but it's okay.
Absolutely.
Well, I'm okay with the bang game as well.
I know.
But you can be sly with it.
Yeah, absolutely. You're right. He had to play the lane just a little bit more than the body, right?
Yeah. And in international, there's a lot of acting. So you can do that too.
Oh, absolutely. Actually, on that note, I talked to Aaron Best last night, and I asked him about the differences between the 905 as well as the international game. And he pointed out the physicality. That was the first thing he talked to me about. Also the style of roughing. You know, they're a little bit looser on the whistle sometimes, but he said that both leagues are very competitive in their own ways, but physicality is definitely one that you notice internationally as well.
Well, we got a couple more seconds here with you, Denise. Real quick, when's the next time we're going to see our women's national team compete?
Well, at the World Championships or the World Cup in September, October in Sydney. So we qualified for that, which is awesome.
Amazing. I know it's an exciting summer, right? When you've got something, September comes quick. So thank you so much again, Denise, for joining us. I mean, again, we just talking to women who have really had their foot on the gas for all of us all these years has been quite incredible. So we celebrate you today and really all the time.
And certainly I celebrate you and all of those who are coming up through the system in all the roles, and in particular with you for media, because without media,